Welcome to Reef and Pond Wise. It's another great day in the hobby. I'm sitting pondside feeding my fish. Now guys, if you're new to the channel and you love reef keeping and pond keeping like I do, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss out on anything. Today's video is about predators, how to keep them away from your pond. I'm going to give you my top five tips as to how I keep predators away from my fish and my pond. So let's get started. Number five is the decoy. Now I've got that alligator and I've got the heron. Now in terms of the blue heron, they're very territorial birds, so I like to move this one around the pond from time to time so that a blue heron won't catch the idea that he's fake. Now, as far as the alligator goes, I can't prove that the alligator is actually doing its job in terms of deterring predators, but I can tell you that just this year, we got ducks a little bit early, and ever since I put that alligator in the pond, I have not seen any ducks. Number four is water movement. Now, if you look at my pond, I've got an awful lot of water movement. And what happens is when you put water movement and get that circulating on top of your pond and in the water, it creates a deflection. So my experience is predators cannot eat what they cannot see. And between the waterfalls and my fountain, the aeration that I'll have going in terms of the pumps here in a little bit, and that other waterfall over there, there's enough ripples in the water that the deflection will deter the predators from seeing or going after my fish. Number three is my dog. I have a schnoodle. His name is Rocky. And if you have a dog, predators pick up on and sense that there's a animal in your yard, so they're more likely to not stop and try to feed on your livestock in your pond if they know that there's a dog. Number two is pond dye. Now, if you've been following me and you've watched some of my previous videos, you'll know that I just dosed pond dye here, and there's several reasons for that. One is what you're looking at now. Look at how brilliant the fish look. When there's that twilight blue pond dye in the backdrop, when you're feeding your fish, they just look brilliant, and I just love it. But if you look a little deeper, you can see that the fish can disappear in very short order to the bottom of the pond, to disappear and not have the sight, the line of sight from a predator. So I like to keep this stocked in the pond throughout the season, and that is my number two choice. And my number one deterrent for predators is a plain old radio. So most predators do not like human voice. So when we're not out here, we'll have a radio on a timer, and it's just a small, inexpensive radio, and we'll keep it on talk radio mostly. And when we're not out here at night, or we're not out here during the day, you can turn it just loud enough where your neighbors aren't bothered by the noise. And as long as the predators can hear human voice, they don't like it. They'll stay away from your pond, and you're more likely not to lose fish and your livestock just based on the background noise. So those are my top five deterrents for predators. Guys, if you like this video, go ahead and smash that like button. And remember, anyone can build a pond, but it takes somebody special to keep one, and that someone special is you.